Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to use character styles in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. All right, first I'm going to open a flyer template that I downloaded from Vectezi to show how character styles work. So I'll open that. And honestly, I would normally use InDesign to do a flyer like this because InDesign is made for this kind of thing and you have a lot more control over there. Now, if you want to skip the explanation by why you would want to use character styles, I'll add a link in my description so you can just jump to the part where we start creating one. So let's say, for whatever reason, we're doing this in Illustrator. So why would you want to use character styles? In this document, a few of the words here and there need to have the same properties. So let's say you want your number text to be larger like this, or maybe you want it to be a different font and let's say purple. And obviously we don't have many words here that we want to make the same, so I probably wouldn't actually use character styles with this few instances. But if you have quite a few words or maybe several artboards with a lot of different text on them, you'll definitely want to make a character style. So normally to change the text, you would just highlight it and then make the change. Maybe you want to change the color or something like this. And that's the manual way to do it. It's kind of a big pain though. There's also a faster way to do it, and that is highlight the text boxes that you want to change, hit I on your keyboard to get to your eyedropper tool right over here, and then just click on the one that you want to end up with for the other two, so you see that it changes the color. And it'll also do this for font and that kind of thing. I'm going to undo back to where we were. The thing about using the eyedropper tool is you still have to do that for every single instance. With character styles, you can set them up once, and then if you want to change the text, you can do it all at once. So let's make a character style. I'll hit T to get into my text box, and I'm going to highlight this number 1. Then I'll open my character styles, which are under Window, Type, and Character Styles. We'll create a new character style, and I'm just going to double-click on the title to rename it Numbers. If you have something already highlighted like we did, it'll give you a character style with all the properties of the highlighted text. And I like starting with something like this, like a font, color size, something like that. If nothing's highlighted, it'll be like starting from scratch. This normal character style up here is the default one that comes standard with Illustrator. So if you highlight some text now and then choose normal character style, I'll hit Z to zoom in. You can see that this has changed it to Myriad Pro 12 points, which is the normal font that comes with Illustrator. So I'm going to undo with Command Z or Control Z. All right, so we have our numbers set up. I'm going to double click in the blank area, not on the text, but in the blank area. This will bring up the character style options. I'll come down here and make sure Preview is checked, and then I'll choose General. This will tell us all the settings that are involved with this character style. If we come to basic character formats, we can start changing it. I'm going to change my font to Nimbus Sans, and when I hit Tab, you'll see it's automatically changed in the document. I want it to be a little bit bigger. I'll make it 81, and I'm going to change it to the lighter green. Now you might notice that the only colors you have access to are the ones in your swatches panel. So if you want other colors, you can set those up and add them to your swatches and then do this. We also have advanced character formats. We can squeeze the type, we can stretch it a little bit vertically, and we can set up rotation and baseline shift here. And we also have open type features. So this looks good for now, so I'll say okay. I'm going to go ahead and select my other two numbers, and I'm going to apply this character style to them. So they all match now. Now let's say the boss comes over and says, okay, well, the client actually wants these to be Arial Bold and wants them to be orange. So like I mentioned before, you'll want to add an orange swatch in first. So I'm going to come over on my color, double click, and come down here to orange. And I'll just pick this one and say okay. And I'll create a new swatch for this. Now we can double click on our numbers character style, open this back up, go to basic character formats, and type in Arial. For font style, we'll choose bold. I'm going to decrease the size a little bit. And of course we want the orange color. And we'll say okay. So by just updating the numbers character style, it has updated all the places that use that character style throughout the document. And now we can create another character style for the subtext if we want. So I'll click on this, and you'll see that it's actually highlighted the normal character style, but it has a little plus button. That means that this text started off as just the Myriad Pro normal, and I overrode that in a lot of ways. I made it larger, different font, color, and all that. So if we want to see what this would look like without the little plus, we can come over here to these three little lines and choose Clear Overrides, and it'll bring it back to what it was before all of the changes I made. I'm going to undo. Anyway, we'll just go ahead and create a new character style. I'm going to double click on the name and call this title. And then I'll click over here in this blank area, double click, to get the options. And we can make all the changes that we want here. We'll say okay. Now another thing you can do with character styles is you can just highlight a few letters and then apply one of these character styles to it. So if we want it to look like the title, we can just hit this one. If we want it to look like numbers, we can hit that one. Now you'll notice that paragraph styles is over here too. Paragraph styles are for whole paragraphs. And actually, when I set up my document, I try to make almost everything a paragraph style first. And then I use the character styles to override parts of my paragraph, if that makes sense. So I would set this up as a paragraph style. And then let's say I wanted to make this bold or a different color. I would use a character style there and then override that. And honestly, I really only use styles in InDesign. All right, if you like this video, please click on the like button, and I'll see you in a couple days with another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.